The way that that internet connection is working, we may as well have David and a bar where everything's free. It's clear now, but I don't know how you are.
Yeah, I don't know. It's the book of Jeremiah. Jeremiah chapter 7, verse 18. The children gather wood, and the fathers kindle the fire. And the woman knead their dough to make cakes to the queen of heaven.
So they worship the queen of heaven. Who is this queen of heaven? They refer to her as Semiramis. Semiramis. It is the worship. This is where the worship of the Trinity comes from. There is no Trinity worship in the Basura. Not when you read it with an understanding. There is no Trinity worship in the Torah or the Tanakh. There is no Trinity worship. This came out of Babylon. And so from Babylon, it went to places like India. And I'm going to go into that. Brahma, Shiva. It's the same Trinity that came, it all came out of Babylon. In Isis, where these Egyptologists that Sharon is caught up into, Isis, Horus, it's the same Trinity. And this is who you're paying homage to. You're paying homage to the Queen of Heaven. So the cakes were initially made in circles because it represented the moon. The moon worship. And they believe in magic. They believe that the moon would give them powers. So they put candles, fire, on the cake. And they would blow out the candles to make a wish. So now you have your little sons and daughters doing this, not even knowing the origin of it. It's pagan in origin. It represents, you said, Tazadaq, that's not the reason I do it. The reason you don't do it for that reason, because you're doing it out of ignorance, but you're still invoking the same spirits. And the Most High does not dwell in a camp that is unclean. So it is generally agreed that cakes was made in the shape of a human being. The original cakes was made in the shape of a human being. And many of these fragments have been found in clay. And so many of these clay fragments would, it literally accented the female features, huh? Which represented the worship of the queen of heaven. This is what Moors are doing when they say woman is a goddess. You're paying homage to the Queen of Heaven. This is why they call Yahuwah God. Because the original language was written from right to left. They taught you to do things backwards. So when you read the word God in its proper context, it would literally be dog. And could we find a worship of a dog anywhere? Yes, we can. The dog-headed god. Half man, half beast. Anubis. So every time you say God, you're paying a homage to Anubis. Every time you blow the candles off a birthday cake, you're worshiping the moon, you're participating in it, you're making wish. We don't make wish. We have faith. We send out prayers. Let's go to Jeremiah 44 and 17. Now this woman, remember, what's her name? Kudar? Empress? Empress told, because that's why I asked if she was a Moor, because you know they're into that heavy. Empress told her to burn incense, sit in a tub, and listen to some different frequency type music. That's invoking spirits, man. You're burning, people will burn incense to the Queen of Heaven. I become very leery when I hear Eve talking about burning incense, using crystals, and so on and so forth. Because all that comes from paganistic origins. Still on Yashabim, man. Get another reader on it. No, Jadir said he was going to be late. Let's go to Jeremiah. For Kadar's joint is not working at all. Jeremiah 44 and 17. Walik Abdul, I can't get him on here. I don't even know if he could read. Huh? You got a third grade education.
It's the book of Jeremiah. Jeremiah chapter 44, verse 17. But we will certainly do whatsoever thing goeth forth out of our own mouth.
So the men in the time of Jeremiah were telling the women, it's the same thing that Sharon does. She doesn't listen to women, to men, right? Whenever a man talks, she try to speak. That's the same spirit that the women had in the time of Jeremiah. They said, sister, you're not supposed to do that. The scriptures say you're supposed to be under your head, which is a man. The scriptures say you're supposed to be taught by your head. The scriptures say, thus saith this, you should pay homage to the man as you do Yahusha. Because it says, honor your husband as unto the Lord in Ephesians. She said, I'm not going to do that. And so that's the same thing they were saying during the time of Jeremiah. They said, well, we hear the word that you're prophesying through the spirit of Yahuwah Yahusha, but we're not going to do that. We're going to do what comes out of our own mouth. Read what you got, King.
Well, even if you go up to verse 15. Come, but we will certainly do whatsoever thing goeth forth out of our own mouth to burn incense unto the Queen of Heaven.
And this is what Catholics do. Many of you Hispanics are caught up into this, burning incense to the Queen of Heaven. A lot of you Eves are caught up into this. Oh, take a bath, a hot bath in a tub and burn incense and put on some vibrational music. You're paying homage to the Queen of Heaven. It's idolatry. Nowhere in the scriptures that it tells you to worship Mary. That is the idolatry. Mary worship. Stop burning incense to the Queen of Heaven. I'm Kahan Tazadaq, and this is Right Knowledge for Vell. This is the truth, and the truth will make you mad.
And pour out drink offerings unto her.
Uh-huh, and pour out liberation unto her. So now, Kadar in the hood, you see every time someone dies, the Negroes are pouring out a little liquor. This is where it came from. This is why I never done that foolishness. That's someone that don't understand what they're doing. They just do things because they heard someone else doing it. But when you're pouring out a little liquor, pull out a little liquor for the homies that's not here, you're doing homage to the Queen of Heaven. That's the origin of that, man. You're burning incense. You're burning incense to the Queen of Heaven. And she told, frankincense is Mars in the Bible, but that's not what you're doing it. You can't call on the name of the Most High because the spirit is very clear. It shows you she don't understand the scriptures. What does the book of Yochanan says? The Most High does not hear the prayers of sinners. So how can this woman, I can't even argue with someone that don't have the capacity to understand when they're being cut. She was like, no, I don't worship. I don't have demons. I said, well, you can't say that you're worshiping the Most High, but you're reading these Egyptian books. That's a sin. The Most High don't hear the prayer of sinners, man. Get that real quick, man. I think it's Yochanan 9. Yeah, God. He don't hear the prayers of sinners, man. So if you're sinning, he's not even hearing your prayers.
Look at Yochanan, John chapter 9, verse 31. Now we know that Yahuwah heareth not sinners. But if any man be a worshiper of Yahuwah and doeth his will, him, he heareth.
So if you're sinning, the Most High not hearing your prayers anymore. So if you want him to hear you again, you have to stop sinning. We didn't interpret anything there that's written verbatim, man. Verbatim. So in the cities of Judah and in the streets of Jerusalem, they was drinks to the queen of. Read verse 15 over there, that you were saying in Jeremiah 44 and 15.
Come. Look at Jeremiah chapter 44, verse 15. Then all the men which knew that their wives had burned incense unto other gods, and all the women that stood by, a great multitude, even all the people that dwelt in the land of Egypt and Pathros, answered Jeremiah, saying, as for the word that thou hast spoken unto us, in the name of the Supreme Allahan, we will not hearken unto thee.
Come. But we're going to do what comes out of our own mouth. Read that part.
Come. But we will certainly do whatsoever thing goeth forth out of our own mouth.
That's basically Sharon in a nutshell.
Facts.
I'm coming at her through the spirit of truth. You know what she's, you know what she's bucking up against it? Because she's not of this fold, man. And like I told her, unless she changes, the Most High is going to jack her up, because the Most High is nothing to play with, man. And that goes for all of you, man. Stephanie, all of you. The Most High is nothing to play with. See, you women, you think you could do what you want to do, man. You honor the man that the Most High put ahead of you, man. And if you women don't have no husband, you're supposed to be honoring the men of the Most High, and that's right over here, the last Nazarene, man. You're supposed to be honoring the priesthood, thus saith the Most High, man. Because you have to be taught right.